Hey, I'm Jenny. I have a reading for you from the Tarot Del Toro and also a review. So if you're thinking about buying this deck, stick around. Okay, so I'll give these guys a good shuffle. There's no wrong way to shuffle cards, by the way. I prefer this for tarot, but I don't shuffle my oracle this way just because with tarot, I want them to be all mixed up. And then I'm just going to pick three cards and see what the messages are. We have Queen of Wands reversed, Knight of Wands reversed, and the Two of Gears. Okay, so with tarot cards, we want to look at the whole story. And so we have two wands coming up and one disc or gear. In a regular deck, this would be pentacles or coins. And so the Queen of Wands, she usually is someone who, you know, it's usually sensuality and empathy and fertility, but when she's upside down, it's more of a manipulation and, you know, less of sincere love and affection. There's some kind of manipulation at play. So there could be someone in your life who is, or in the past, who has manipulated you using their affection and their love, and most likely was a woman or very feminine. And so if this is the case that's going on, you recognize this person in your life now, it's suggested that you sort of cut, you know, you cut cords from this person and you let that go. And then the Knight of Wands reversed is like an excess of energy. So there's a manipulation going on. And then it may be as a result of that, there's a lot of energy that is just being dispersed everywhere. And it's kind of like you don't know what to do. When we've been manipulated and we realize it, we feel really unsafe and really not good. And so if you've been through something like that, your energy could be all over the place. So really cutting cords from that person and reclaiming your energy will really help you feel better. And then you'll be back to a balance. And whenever we get discs or coins or pentacles, they're always they're earth. They're represented by the element of earth and a lot of times prosperity. And so it looks like if these two situations get taken care of, we're going to be back to a balance in our lives and feeling more grounded. And I hope this resonates with you. So I'm going to be totally honest with you. Yes, I read tarot cards. No, I did not get this deck because I thought I would actually use it for reading. I am a huge Guillermo Del Toro fan. I got to see his collection At Home with Monsters at the LACMA, and I love his art. I love his monsters. I love his movies. And so I saw the deck and I thought I have to have this. And I thought at the very least, I'll probably just display it at the home. I can do some like clear frames and display some of the cards. And I really didn't think I'd use it for readings because I just thought it's based on movies, like it's probably not that good. But I was really wrong. So I want to say that it's actually created by Tomas Hijo. And what he does is he uses wood cuts. So he carves every single one of these cards and then prints them and then they get colored. And the detail is very beautiful. It's somehow timeless. And just you can see like all the wood cut detail in it. And it's just, I know it's weird to say, but it's beautiful. Like it's, yeah, this is very, you know, very Guillermo del Toro. It draws on all of his movies. There are lots of monsters. None of the cards, I would say, look happy. There's a very creepy, grotesque element to them. But if you're into that, then this is a really great deck for you. Or maybe the deck you use every Halloween time, right? It's just for that. I will say that when I was reading the reviews on Amazon, people said that the regular Arcana cards were not that detailed. They said it was, you know, they were disappointed in it, but I'm not. I think, you know, they play a minor role anyway as a reader, and you really don't need much more than the number and the symbol. And so I think that it doesn't detract at all from the deck. And like I said, I mean, everything is hand carved. So I feel like that's asking too much. I feel like this is significant. This is good. It's very, these are minimalist, whereas the others are more, you know, there's a lot going on in these cards. And so, you know, I just want to point that out so people will put the deck down for that, which I think is not really fair at all. And the case itself is really nice. In fact, I usually don't keep my cards in the case, but I like it. I like how it's lined. There's a little ribbon in here. The booklet is really nice quality. And what's interesting about this is Guillermo del Toro reads tarot. No surprise there, I think. And he actually learned from his mother. His mother did, and he talks about that story in here. And Tomas Hijo somehow meets him and suggests, like, let's do this. But they both, and by the way, the magician is Guillermo. They both read tarot and they honor it as a sacred art. And so they didn't want to just make a silly deck based off of his movies. It had to be done in a way that would honor the tradition. And so what Tomas Hijo does, the artist, is he finds this man named Don Miguel in his town who's the most respected of the tarot readers. He's been doing it for a really long time. And in fact, his reading, one of his own spreads is in here. He shares it in the book, which is really cool. And he asks him to help him. And at first, Don Miguel's like, that's no, you can't do that. You can't make a deck based off of, you know, movies. This is absurd. But he shows him the movies, and together, like, the Don Miguel's actually blind. So he like tells him what's going on in the movies, and together they're able to create a deck that honors the traditional tarot, but is infused with the imagination and the artwork of Guillermo del Toro, which I'm blown away. Like, the readings are very accurate. They're not hokey. That was my thing. I thought this is just going to be kind of goofy. You know, some of my favorite movie. Well, I think my favorite movie is Pan's Labyrinth. Sometimes I think it's actually Kronos. But, you know, you have these characters. And I don't know. There is something creepy and strange about the actual original tarot decks. And so I think that that is really brought to life here. And for those of us who like to delve deep into shadow work and aren't afraid of that darkness, it's exciting. It's an exciting deck to have. I also think that the booklet is really helpful. It's sort of minimal in descriptions of the minor cards, because those are, but the major cards have a really good description. And there's a lot of quotes, like the devil card, to learn what we fear is to learn who we are. And that's from Guillermo del Toro. And then some are from the movies. And I mean, it's just so well thought out. And then I think the most valuable thing about this deck is that Tomas Hijo shares that the tarot cards are not meant to be a one card pull, but when you have them together, they are meant to be a story. And that's actually how a good reader reads the tarot cards. They lay the cards out and they feel and they come up with a story, which is why he felt that he could use the stories and the imaginations of Guillermo del Toro to create a deck, because it's all based on story. And he even said that some of the greatest writers of all time have used the tarot to help guide them in their writing. So yeah, I just think it's a gorgeous deck. If you love Guillermo del Toro movie, you love tarot, like, don't hesitate. Like, I think this is an amazing deck. And even if you're just looking for just something different, you want something that's a real piece of art, and you want something that is going to just, you know, be different than any other deck you have, then I would really suggest this. You know, these are really unique. They are real pieces of art. The cards feel really nice. They have the waxed coating. They're a good size. I think they're great. And I know that the artist is coming up with a Labyrinth deck. And so I might have to get that too and review that as well. So yeah, I just feel that this is a really well thought out update on the tarot. It's not at all hokey. And I don't think you're really going to feel like this person was trying to make things work, like, you know, forcing it. It really, the movies, the imagination of Guillermo del Toro goes so well with the tarot, it's kind of ridiculous. So I highly recommend it for anybody who's thought about giving it a try.